Good morning from the hills. I'm in Chikmagaluru, often called the land of coffee, nestled in the Western Ghats of South India. This region is a tapestry of lofty mountain ranges, dense rainforests, and endless stretches of coffee plantations. Right now, it's monsoon season, and the hills are in their vibrant prime. The air filled with the chorus of birds and insects, the rumble of waterfalls, and the constant freshness that only rain can bring. Along the winding misty roads, moss and ferns flourish in abundance. Some of the most vibrant green walls I've ever seen are draped here. Look at this lush curtain of maidenhair ferns, perhaps the largest I've seen. For anyone who loves nature, this is paradise. The rain has just eased and it feels wonderful to be out wandering. I'm staying at a coffee farm, much like many others in the area, with a winding pathway that leads to open views of the surrounding mountains. These nature walks are a simple joy, a luxury for those of us used to the fast pace of city life. Since I am here, I can't resist doing some moss spotting. This wasn't a planned trip, so I did not bring my usual shooting gear. The footage is captured on my iPhone, handheld, so it may be a little shaky. I also forgot my magnifying glass, but thankfully I carry a small Fresnel lens in my wallet for moments just like this. Here in the monsoon-soaked hills, moss is everywhere, carpeting walls, climbing tree trunks, nestling between stones. If you know what you're looking for, it's impossible to miss. Here's a beautiful colony of Leucodon sciuroides, also known as squirrel-tail moss. It's a cosmopolitan species found across many parts of the world and adaptable to a variety of climates and conditions. Just beneath it, I spotted a pleasant surprise, Octoblepharum albidum, one of my favorites, which I rarely see in these regions. A little further along, I found a dense patch of Funaria hygrometrica, or cod moss. Though common in India, this species has a wide distribution and thrives in moist, shaded environments worldwide. Nearby, there were clusters of Syntrichia ruralis, also called twisted moss or star moss, native to tropical parts of Asia. As I climbed higher, the trees became increasingly adorned with moss, entire trunks layered with multiple species, living in perfect harmony. I could spot cushion moss, medusa moss, star moss, fork moss, and a few ragged trailing species that might be hypnum or brachythecium, though I cannot be certain. Many orchids and other epiphytic species also appear to be thriving here, nestled comfortably among the mosses. I'm certain the edges of the waterfalls along the way shelter a rich variety of moss species, though getting close enough for a proper look is quite a challenge. I left the winding mountain roads behind and began the climb towards the steep slopes near the peak. Here the wind is strong and the mist drifts through in waves. When it clears, the views are nothing short of spectacular. Here I spotted tufts of Dicranum, also known as mood moss, tucked among the rocks. These mosses prefer cooler conditions, which explains their presence at higher altitudes. I also came across what appears to be a Bryum species, possibly Bryum elegans. Bryum mosses are abundant in the Western Ghats, but identifying them precisely requires careful study with field guides and references. If you happen to know this exact species, feel free to share it in the comments. Moss identification is a patient process, and it's easy to get it wrong. I could spend days here lost in this green world. If you know me, you know my love for moss runs deep. I hope you enjoyed joining me on this nature walk. Until next time, happy moss spotting.